purpose is how I can raise up ordinary men, turning them to become supernatural beings, financial apostles, making life better, bringing people from the dungeon of sin, bringing them into the faith, planting their feet, and rising them.
What he knows! What he knows!
If one pastor gets it right, 60 million souls can be saved. Our problem in Africa is leadership problem. And that's why I'm so passionate about leadership. I am your brother, Brother Joshua Igila. When we read one scripture, then we have our seat, then I will want one pastor to stay by the mic and will help me when this time comes. You will read some other scripture for us to help. Now, I just want us to take our Bible to the book of Mark, chapter 10. We will remain standing and read it, then we have our seat, if you don't mind. Mark, chapter 10. I want to read from verse 43. Mark chapter 10 from verse 43. Are we there? But so shall it not be among you, but whosoever will be great among you shall be your minister. And whosoever of you will be the chiefest shall be a servant of all. Shall we read it all together? One, two, go. Among you, but whosoever will be great among you shall be your minister. And whosoever will be the chiefest shall be a servant of all. Psalm 23, verse 1 and 2. Psalm chapter 23. We read from verse 1 and 2. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pasture. He leadeth me beside the still water. He restored my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. May the Lord bless the reading of his word. Amen. Sit down on your enemy's head. Amen. I'm sure they are screaming. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. God wants to talk to us on what I titled, Making a Difference in Life and Ministry. 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 Some pastors are particular about ministry and they forget that their life is also important. If your life must be better, you must understand that ministry is one thing and your life is one thing. And hear this, for people to follow your ministry, they want to see the man behind the ministry. And that's your life. And when I talk about your life, your marital life, your children, your personal success. If you are not successful personally, you cannot be great as a pastor. You must understand, before God gave Adam the ministry of dressing and keeping the vineyard, God made his life better. All that Adam need to raise up a beautiful home was created. God created the Garden of Eden and put everything that Adam needed in that garden. Then he placed Adam and then commissioned Adam. And hear this, God gave Adam a family first before a ministry. And the greatest problem we have in ministry, we don't understand that if your family is bad, your ministry will be bad. Some pastors are too anointed that they can't take care of their wives. Straight talk today. I hope you'll not be offended. Some pastors are too offended, are too anointed that they don't even know the school their children attend. They are too anointed that they don't have time to pray for their children. I have watched that the statistic of wayward children, when you look at it, is common among leaders. Too busy that they are not busy for the family. What is the excess of you to be great and you don't have time for your wife, your children, and the house? If you must be a problem solver for other people, you must also solve your own problem. How many pastors' wives are crying secretly and everybody are celebrating papa, fire, glory, and the wife is saying no glory here? Am I talking to somebody here? You pray for people in the church and give them attention, but you can't give your wife attention. You can't give your wife attention. You see it now, making a difference in life and ministry. Your life is one thing and your ministry is another thing. I have seen pastor for 50 years and no land, no house of their own. And they are yet anointed. And they have money. They can buy expensive suit, but they cannot buy expensive land to build a house for the wife and the children. No wonder some women don't even want to marry pastors, because they know the next thing they will do is fire. Yeah. Do you know what it means to be a minister of God? It means you are employed by the Federal Republic of Heaven. It means that God employed you. It is a noble job, a job of integrity, a job that is highly honorable than the position of a president. Am I talking to somebody here? So your life is very important. Your life is very important. God wants you to excel. There are people you can't touch. They have to look at you and say, is he even succeeding? Making a difference in life and ministry. God wants you to be exceptionally great as a leader. God want you to be exceptionally great. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me. It is God that is going to make you. He maketh me to lie down. I'm not the one that will make myself. If God does not make you, you are a gallant failure. God will make you to lie down. He will make you to lie down. He will make you to lie down. We are in greener pasture. God is raising up exceptional leaders.
You are not created to be small as a pastor. When I mean small, you are not created to pastor just a small ministry. No, you can start small but end big. Though your beginning might be small, but your latter end, according to the scripture, shall greatly what? Increase. I'm talking to people here who are exceptional leaders. If you want to have great followership, you must be a great follower. If you don't let, the greatest thing I have seen among pastors is that we don't want to sit down to listen to one another. Who is that one talking there? Change the channel. What is he saying? We are too proud to listen. Now listen to me. Any man that is above you politically, spiritually as a leader, or physically, or in business wise, above you in life, knows what you don't know. He knows what you don't know. Hear this. Excellency and greatness as a leader, hear this, it's not the function of durability and age. If you are conscious of age, you become an adage. What has the age of Methuselah got to do with the exploit of Jesus? Look, I'm not against title, but there is a problem when your title is higher than your work. There are people bearing archbishop, the right apostle, the very middle apostle, and the center apostle. Now, there is nothing wrong with the title, but please let your title not be higher than your work. Do the work of a bishop. Do the work of an apostle. If you're an apostle, let us see you do the work of an apostle. If you're a prophet, let us see you do the work of a prophet. Don't call yourself a prophet when you are a teacher. Am I talking here? Hey, am I talking here? Yes. Ministry is all about maturity. The title is not important as the task. It is the task that defines the title. It is the task that validates the title. It is not the title that validates the task. The task is the assignment. And you must understand that your assignment is greater than the commendation of men. Get me right. Bearing any title is not a sin, but it becomes a criminal offense when you are archbishop and yet you are having three members. What are you acting and bishoping? Can I say something here? Making a difference in ministry and life is not all about gender. You can be a woman or a man. You can create exploits. Can I say something here? Don't look down on women. They are too important in ministry. Hear this. As a pastor, if you want to do well, know how to honor women very, very well. Check your ministry. The population of women are higher. If your church have more male than female, I can tell you there will be problem very soon. And hear this. Women are too peculiar in ministry. Look, without them today, you and I will not be Christians. You don't you see, after the resurrection, all the disciples went their way. None of them even remember to go to the sepulchre. It was Mary Magdalene and the other Mary that went there to check. My God! My God! Do you know what the angel told them? He said, "Why seek ye the living among the dead? For he's no longer here, for he has risen. Go and tell the brethren." So they were the one that went to convert the 12 disciples back again to their prophecy. Somebody shout fire. Fire. Hi, yeah, 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 yeah. Shout fire. If you're a sister here and you are called to ministry, I can assure you, you will make a difference. If Maria Wudo Ekta can do it, Kenji Kuma can do it, Esther can do it, Deborah in the Bible can do it, you are going to do it. Am I talking to somebody here? Say, I'm loaded. I cannot fail. The secret of making a difference in ministry. Number one, you must be a problem solver. John chapter 6 verse 35, Acts chapter 10 verse 38. You must be a problem solver. If you are not a problem solver, you cannot be great and make a difference in ministry. Ministry is all about solving problems. Did you hear what I'm saying? Ministry is all about what? Solving problems. Any member can die for you as a pastor if you solve their problem. Now hear this. There's one thing to be a preacher and there's one thing to be a problem solver. That means if my member comes in with headache, if I lay my hands on her and the headache goes away, she will not leave me. That means if my member comes to me and asks, "Papa, I want to marry between these two brother, which one is God saying?" What do you do? You now look at her and say, "Okay, you cannot hear from God. You are not a problem solver." You see here why people fight the prophetic ministry. I yet don't understand. Okay, a member come to me to and said, "I'm confused. Papa, tell me, which one is God saying is my husband?" That shows that she believes you are a man of God and that you can hear from God. This has nothing to do with prophecy now. This has nothing to do with "I am a prophet." This has something to do with you are a man from God and you should hear the voice of your father. And if you cannot hear the voice of your father, you are a bastard. Can I talk here? Do you know what Jesus said? "I know my sheep and my sheep knows me. And when they hear my voice, they will come. The voice of a stranger will they not hear." It's an error for a pastor not to hear the voice of God. Hey, people come with malaria fever, and when they are going out of your church, they go out with iPod Plus. You are not a problem solver. Oh, you don't get what I'm saying. For you to make a difference in ministry, you must be a problem solver. Ministry is all about solving problems for people. You give them knowledge, you give them information, you give them revelation, and you transform their life. They can die for you for that. Hear this. If your members are leaving you to another church, don't fight the pastor. Go and do your homework. Did you hear what I say? If your members are leaving you for another pastor, don't fight the pastor. Improve your quality. Number two, how do you make a difference in ministry? You must believe in your product.
John chapter 4, verse 13. I don't know. Can I get somebody who can get the mic to read for me as I declare the scripture? John chapter 4. You can just stay somewhere. And John chapter 4, verse 13 to 14. Are we there? I want us to get the scripture, because I'm talking with pastor here. Are we there? 4 verse 13.
John chapter 4.
Yeah.
And verse 13.
Yes.
And the Bible reads.
Yeah.
Jesus answered, every person who drinks this water will be thirsty again. 14. But whoever drinks the water
that I will give, go on,
I give will never be thirsty again. The water I will give, will become a spring of water flowing inside him.
Look at that. Thank you. Look at that. Jesus was advertising his product. Say, anyone that drinks this natural water shall be thirsty. But the water that I will give, is a spring of everlasting water. If you must make a difference in ministry, blow your trumpet yourself. If you don't know how to talk about your ministry, you can't go far. Advertise your product. Believe your product. Before you convince me, you must convince yourself. You don't come and tell me, maybe God will heal you. When you tell me, maybe God will heal you, maybe I will not follow you. You must be sure. You must be sure of what you are saying. If you are not sure of what you are saying, why should I follow you? Believe in your product. Talk about your product. Anywhere you are going, talk about it. I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God to them that believe. I am not ashamed. When I am in the aircraft, I talk about Jesus. If you sit down around me, you are in soup if you are not born again. I will get you troubled, I will talk. Am I talking to somebody here? Talk about your product. Don't hide your Bible as a pastor.
Hi.
You must not only be a pastor in the church, and when you go out, nobody knows you as a pastor. You wear face cap and hide yourself. What are you hiding yourself for? Are you a criminal? If you don't plan, you can't make it. It is only in the ministry we speak in tongues and we don't plan. You are not planning to buy a land. You are still renting a place. And when they ask you, say it is well, it is wrong. I say it is wrong. You are renting a place for 7 years and you have bought 2 cars. My brother, that's a body. Sell that car and go and buy a land for your church. Can I talk here? You don't have a land for church, but you have built your personal house. That's your priority. I started my ministry with 215 naira, and I don't know that in dollars. That should be about approximately $2. The one you see on air. And that was about 7 years and 9 months or 11 months old ministry that you see all over. 7 years and 10 months old ministry that you see all over the world. I wasn't born with a silver spoon. In fact, I was so very poor that the poor people around me were calling me poor. That's to tell you my ratio of poverty. I was preaching like this in a program that was sent to go and preach. Powerful message. I share this anywhere I go. Powerful message. Preaching powerfully. Because my shoe has gone through evangelism and suffering. There is a way you have used your shoe, and the shoe is saying, help us. They are crying for help because of suffering. I was on the altar, you know, I like saying, lift up your leg and shout fire. When I say, lift up your leg and shout fire, the soul came down, and it was only this. It was only the stockings, and the stocking, my big toe was showing there. I'm telling you the level of my suffering those days. And 3 sisters were sitting at the front. They were busy looking at what was going on. Immediately I saw that the shoe, I came, I hide myself. I used the pulpit to hide myself. Then all the rhema I wanted to preach disappeared. Then I keep saying, amen. 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 Poverty can cast out your revelation. God punished poverty. I was saying, amen. I forgot what I wanted to say. That time, all the anointing in me went down to the lowest minimum. Then the 3 sisters at the front, they were looking at my leg. They were telling each other, members can gossip their pastor. This is me that they were all shouting fire. By that time now, they now started looking at my leg. They were inching each other. Did you see what I saw? They were telling each other. And as they were talking, they were looking at my leg. Then I could not move any further, any longer to walk around. I was by the pulpit like a prisoner. Can I talk here? Then I discovered that I have to escape for my life. Because there's no message I can preach there. Then I say, all head bow. It's time for prayer. When I say, all head bow, everybody bowed their head. These 3 sisters, they did not bow their head. They were telling themselves, this film, we will watch it finish. It's a movie, we must watch it finish. Then I re-emphasize. I say, I mean everybody, all eyes closed, all head bow. They did not bow their head. They were looking at my shoe. I repeated it the third time. They didn't answer me. So I immediately, when I saw that all about, I gave them one dangerous prayer point to pray. they were praying it, I carried the sole of my shoe. I was going like this. The three sisters followed me with their eyes. And they were laughing. God punished poverty.
Are you blessed? We are just starting. Another secret of exploit in ministry, you must be prepared for rejection, betrayal, for they are inevitable. If you must make a difference in ministry, be prepared for rejection, betrayal. They are inevitable. So because of your anointing or your calling or your speed, and people around you will betray you. If you have 12 members, there's one Judas. 24 members, 2 Judas. 36 members, 3 Judas. Go on like that. Imagine if you have 1,000 members, calculate how many Judas you have. They are around. They will tell you, Papa! And they will backstab you. Be prepared for that. And hear this. Your ability to manage it, love them, and focus on your ministry makes you a great man. I have conditioned my mind as a father never in my life to ever place a curse on any son in ministry. It doesn't matter what you have done. I want to make heaven and I don't want to lose heaven. So before you offend me, I forgive you in advance. When I see people who call themselves fathers placing curse on children, is one of the signs of immaturity. I am too focused on my assignment to place curse. Because the child that betrayed you today can become a chief corner child later. We are not trained to kill generals. We are trained to groom generals up. You'll be rejected. There are some of you who are into prophetic ministry and people have called you all kind of names. The fact that they are criticizing you does not make you not to be a real man of God. Everybody has an opinion. An opinion is opinion. But hear this. What man says about you is not what God says about you. God owns the final say to your ministry. Some people have left deliverance, power ministry, because of the way you are criticized. People who criticize you, they love what you are doing, but they don't have it. You don't know? They try it on their member. Fire. They look at them. How can I prophesy? They look around. The more they look, they can't see. Hear this. When you see a man talking about you, the man has submitted himself under you. You know, when we were planning to come here, some people tried to do some schemes to block me from coming into Zambia. That's to show you our ministries. That's how people are. Some people have made themselves a demigod. They are afraid of another man's speed. And that's Pentecostal witchcraft. Some people think it's when they are flying in the night that they become winch. When you fight another man of God like you, you are a winch. How do you make a difference in ministry? You must
have something others are in high demand for. If you want to be in high command, be in high demand. Why do you drink water? It's necessary. You must lay value on yourself and become a commodity in high demand. And it has to do with quality and not quantity. If you have an healing anointing, people who are sick will look for you. If you have the prophetic anointing, those who want direction will look for you. If you have the word, those who are looking for the word will come. The problem with people in the prophetic ministry is that you build your ministry on prophecy and not the word. If you prophesy without the word, you are still in primary school. You are still in the nursery school. The word is the stabilizer of every prophetic ministry. And if you have the word without the gifting, spiritual corporal punishment, you are punishing yourself. Because after you teach powerful message, what follows? So if there is no sign that follow, you are a commentator. In fact, there's no difference between you and a lecturer in the university. A lecturer talk, and you too, you are also what? A talker. But what follows? For the kingdom of God is not in words, but it is in the demonstration of the power of God. Tell anybody, I believe.
I believe.
I believe.
I believe.
Can I say this? If you want to make a difference in ministry, you are not born to solve all problems, and you cannot solve all problems. Why are you looking at me that way? You are surprised? You are not born to solve all problems. Imagine if Benihim healed all the sick. Which one are you going to heal? If Renabonki win all the soul, which one are you going to win? What does that mean? It means that any problem you can't solve, you are not sent to them. So, what should be your prayer? Oh Lord, bring members that I am sent to. If you know this, there will be no need for you to look for power where there is no power. You are not born to solve all problems, and you cannot solve all problems. It is the Messiah, which is Jesus, that is born to solve all life problems. Any miracle you can perform does not make you unanointed. It simply means you were not sent to them. Oh, am I teaching you something here? Are you getting that? Are you understanding this? Because the same man who raised one cripple here might not be able to raise another cripple there. He does not mean the anointing is not there. He is not sent to them. Because it might be a village pastor that might raise that cripple. I see a change. I see a change. I see a change. You must understand preparation and timing is essential in making difference in ministry. John 2, chapter 4, verse 4, Jesus waited for 30 years to prepare for 3 years ministry. If you are in a rush, if you are in a rush to start ministry, you will rush out. He It means Jesus spent 10 years to prepare for 1 year ministry. How high your preparation is how high your manifestation will be. No preparation, no manifestation. In ministry, you must learn how to prepare. Prepare your message. If you don't prepare your message, you will not bless your flocks. Don't come to the altar and be doing tinkle, tinkle, little star. How I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. All you are doing is rhyme. I said, the Lord will bless you. I said, the Lord will bless you. I said, yes, now you say, the Lord will bless me. What next? No message. No message. Rhyme. Rhyme. How can you be a messenger without a message? How can you be a messenger without a message? Last Sunday, you talk about Holy Ghost fire. This Sunday again, see Holy Ghost fire. Next Sunday again, Holy Ghost fire. When are we going to hear about the blood of fire? Do you know what I'm talking about? In your church, there are lecturers, there are professors, there are medical doctors. And if you don't have one, it's because you are not prepared for them. If they come around you and they sit down and listen to you, and they discover that your content is empty, they will leave you. There are people who come to your ministry not because they need healing. The Holy want to hear something that will transform their life. They are in pursuit for knowledge. Read. Read. Get books of other authors. Read. Study to show yourself approved as a workman that needed not to be ashamed, but rightly divided the word of truth. You must understand, when you study, your life and ministry will be steady. If you are a reader, you are a leader. If you are a reader, you are a leader. When you're a pastor, you don't even read the word of God. On Sunday, early in the morning, you just carry the Bible. Anywhere open, that's the message for today. And you open and say, and Elijah killed the prophet of Baal. Say, today, Elijah killed the prophet of Baal. Am I helping you? Am I helping you? Do you know that there is time for everything? If your time has not come, don't kill yourself. Even though you put your head down and lift your two head up, nobody will follow you. Shout fire, la la, I don't say la la. No matter what you do, if your time has not come, people will not follow you. Hear this, I pastored 120 members for 7 good years, and it dropped down to 40 members. I thought church is supposed to go up. My own was going down. And I will come to the altar well prepared, because the time has not come. If you have done all that you need to do and nothing is changing your ministry, don't help God. Wait for your time. Job said, all the days of my life, I will wait until my time comes. There is time for it. Now hear this. It's just the time of Brother Joshua. That's why I'm on the altar to teach you. It doesn't make me better than you. Am I talking to somebody here? When your time comes to climb this stage, nobody can stop you. What do I mean? When your time comes for the world to hear you, nobody can stop you. Don't borrow money. Don't borrow money to go and buy a land. And now the bank wants to take over the land. Wait for their time. Your friend came and parked a car and said, man of God, God just blessed me with a Land Cruiser. I said, wow, you are looking for your own Land Cruiser. You will kill yourself. Wait for your own time. If you are not qualified to fill a stadium in crusade, don't force yourself. Take it gradually. Because you can organize program and have high blood pressure at the end of the whole day.
Why are they laughing like this? Somebody say, my time has come. Say, my time has come. I know what I carry. I know who I am. I'm too loaded to fail. Whatever he has written concerning me, I will become. Say, brethren, I am loaded. I will not fail. Because my time has come. Shout it like thunder. Shout it like thunder. I am an exceptional leader. I want to quickly do this. Jesus told the disciple, follow me, for I will make you fishers of men. That's it. That's the reason why we follow him, for him to make us fishers of men. Greatness in ministries is achievable and is obtainable and attainable.